Hello friends, welcome back. In this tutorial, we will study about input-output versus memory bus. In addition to communicating with the input-output devices, CPU has to communicate with memory unit also. Like input-output bus, memory bus contains data lines, address lines, and read-write control lines. So there are three ways that computer buses can be used to communicate with memory and input-output. First method is using two separate buses, one for memory and the other for input output. This method is used when the computer is having an input output processor, a separate input output processor in addition to the CPU. In this case, memory unit communicates with CPU and input output processor through memory bus, and the input output processor communicates with the input and output devices by input output bus. So in this case, there is an independent pathway for the transfer of information between external devices and internal memory. Second method is using one common bus for both memory and input output, but separate control lines. This method is called isolated input output method. In this method, computer uses one common bus to transfer information between memory or input output and CPU. The distinction between a memory transfer and input output transfer is made through separate read and write control lines. During input output transfer, the input output read and input output write control lines are enabled. During memory transfer, the memory read and memory write control lines are enabled. When input-output read and input-output write control lines are enabled, then it specifies the address on address lines is for interface register. When memory read and memory write control lines are enabled, then it specifies the address on address lines is for memory word. In the isolated input-output configuration, the CPU has distinct input and output instructions, and each of these instructions is associated with address of an interface register. So when CPU decodes the operation code of the input or output instruction, it places the address on address line. And at the same time, it activates the input output read or input output write control line. And this informs the input output devices that the address on address line is for interface register. It is not for some memory word. So when the CPU communicates with the memory, what it does, it places the address on address line, and it activates either memory read or memory write control line. So this informs the input output devices that the address on address line is for memory word, not for input output interface. The isolated input output method isolates memory and input output addresses. Each has its own address space. Now the third method is using one common bus for both memory and input output with common control lines. This method is called memory mapped input output method. In this configuration, computer treats the interface register as a part of memory system. Same address space is used for both memory and input output. Now the addresses which are assigned for interface registers cannot be used for memory words. So in memory mapped input output method, there are no specific input or output instructions. CPU can manipulate input output data, which is in interface register, with the same instructions that are used to manipulate memory words. In computers with the memory mapped input output configuration, memory type instructions are used to access input output data. So it allows the computer to use the same instructions for both input and output transfers and for memory transfer.